Yeah. downgrading the importance of his mother. He knew his mother was outside. They say his brothers, sisters meaning his brothers, husbands or whatever. But what's more important, the father's will of his place. Now his blessed mother, Mary, our mother, knew that perfectly well. In fact, with her famous fiat, she opened the door and her life was a constant, yes, a fiat to the will of God. Fiat the woman does to us when the bird on the floor. God was her whole life. So she knew perfectly well, standing outside, and I'm sure she didn't pressure anyone in any way, shape, or form. She probably didn't say, tell my son that I'm here. She knew he was busy doing the will of the Father. And so that's if you read that, it's perfect love. Now, we all have our earthly mothers. They've been passed away. As good as they are, but motherhood, maternity, comes from the hands of Almighty God. God is the creator of motherhood. And we obey our mothers, we give honor to our mothers, even when they're deceased, by praying for them, remembering them, offering masses for them, and giving glory and honor to God. Now, the best way to honor our mother is to give glory and honor to God. And the best way to give glory and honor to our Lord is to not listen to the word of God, found in sacred scripture, taught to us by Holy Mother the Church, but also put it into practice. Mary's life was a constant putting into practice the word of God. Each and every day of her life, where God would have called her to go into Egypt, the difficulties, the sufferings of protecting her son. The word of God, when it made her stand by the foot of the cross, and at that moment of intense agony and pain, seeing her own beloved son die on the cross. And the word of God finally brought her to the first Pentecost Sunday, where together, united with the apostles, she together